We have a guest who is a wonderful London writer, and she knew Roy McDonald, and I'm sure she has some good stories for you. Will you please welcome a noted London writer, Patricia Black.
Maniac. Bowman, it's a Bowman. Not Donald Hall. Agency of long lost mayor. Celebrant of synchronicity. Oh, please, sit on my face. That last line is, was apparently a plea Roy had made to a young woman in Montreal one time. It also appears in Jason's play. I found a copy of notes I jotted about the first read-through of that play, which took place at the Forest City Gallery in November 99, with Jeff Cockburn, over in the back there, as Roy. The play was later presented in the McManus Theatre, and later still by Adam Corrigan Horowitz, with Chris McCauley as Roy. I made handwritten notes of the reading. I was a theater columnist for Scene magazine at the time. I'm not sure if it ever made it into Scene, but some of Roy's quotes about the read-through. I am bowled over. I think it is a brilliant play, so well acted. I'm almost at a loss for words. And Roy about himself. I am a play, a rather engrossing one. And also, Jason captured so well in writing what I was going through. I was close to tears. I must add that both productions of Beard were excellent. Anyone who saw either or both will never forget Roy joining the actor Roy on stage at the end of the play, both singing I Did It My Way. Jason's upcoming play, I would just put in a plug here, is about autism. Called Lunar Landing. It's coming to the Arts Project from the 21st to the 24th, right, Jason? You're welcome. Proceeds going to Autism Ontario, I believe. Also tucked away in my file from Roy's 50th birthday, I have probably some letters from Premier David Peterson, Mayor Tom Gosnell, lists of invitees. We had decided we would ask 50 people to write 50 words about Roy. There were many quite well-known writers and mother and brother of the field who were invited. Our town crier here, J.R. Colombo, Gwendolyn McEwen, Ross Woodman, Herman Gooden, I see over away at the back, Stan Dratton, Greg Curnow, Ed Phelps, Yaroslav Pavelka, Don McKay, Orr Miller, Marty Favreau, and many others. And there were other gifts for Roy besides the poems. One in particular I remember was a mobile of 50 origami frames made for Roy by London storyteller Diane Malkin. It was an amazing occasion. I had even written down a rough itinerary for the evening. After the more formal program, I noted we would all sing happy birthday, Roy would have his birthday cake, followed by his speech and the opening of gifts. At 10 p.m., and I love this note, there would be a free-for-all visitation accompanied by peanuts, pretzels, and a cash bar. I'm thinking the sumptuous feast here today is a little improvement on the pretzels and peanuts, but there's Chris McCauley, I see him. I just talked about you, Chris. And I just will quickly summarize one of my most amazing and memorable encounters with Roy. So this made its way into a story which I told at one of Adam Horowitz's storytelling nights. I was standing in a lineup at Union Station, coming back to London, having visited my family in Port Hope. So I'm standing in the lineup. I just happened to have in my purse a small piece of the Berlin Wall. How many people carry a piece of the Berlin Wall around in it? My nephew had given this to me. Roy appeared through an archway when he came to the station. Made a beeline, of course, for me. So we're chatting, he's pulling books out of his bag, telling Roy is what we should do. After a while, lineup still had to move. I took my piece of book out of my purse, put it into his cup hands, and I said, Roy, can you guess what this is? Well, he couldn't guess what it was, so finally I said, it's a piece of the Berlin Wall. So he raised his two cup hands, his eyes to heaven, as if it was some sort of unholy relic. And then put it back in my purse, my mind, I'm starting to read. He went his way and I went mine. And I always think, anyone in that crowd observing this, people bothered, would think, what the heck was happening to me? It's a lovely story. When I saw Roy here at his 80th, his voice was very faint. I don't know if people had learned this about Roy in the last few years. He told me about his Parkinson's disease. So I said, well, that could be the voice that we did for the Parkinson's. The last time I happened to see him was the launch of Vanessa Brown and Jason Dixon's wonderful book, London 150 Pops or Moments. And congratulations to Jason and Vanessa. They just won the Ontario Heritage Award. Roy was sitting on Richmond Street outside the store, proudly showing off his page from the book, which was headed, Roy McDonald Gets Picked Off Campus. Many of you here will remember that notorious story. When I asked him to sign my copy of the book, he said, you know, you thought my pain voice might be due to my Parkinson's. Well, it isn't. It's because my gums are sharp and my teeth don't fit. So that's my last conversation with our beloved boy, who we will surely miss you, but you are still so much a presence.